a political slasher. It's a satire on a little bit about the political system in the United States, mixed with your very classic, satisfying slasher film.
Yeah. And in terms of you, I imagine you were sort of playing a sort of a teenage sort of school role and adolescent role. I suspect I could be wrong, but I suspect I've only seen the trailer. And I suspect that's the type of role you're playing in the movie in terms of that. So is it very much are you on the run in terms of the movie? And are you on the run towards the middle, towards the start, or towards the end?
So I can't give too much away, but yes, it's starts off on the cusp of a mayoral election. So the current mayor of the town it's set in, I'm her daughter. So my character gets mixed into the whole mess and mystery that ensues throughout the movie.
And it's definitely a suspense. It's a sort of psychological thriller. It's a guess who sort of scenario. You're sort of wondering, turning over and tossing between characters over and back to say, you're sort of giving you small little hints away. It's just sort of baiting you towards one, and then that's coming up short. So there's a bit of a puzzle, dare I say, in terms of working through a maze to eventually for the audience to try and find the killer themselves.
Exactly. Throughout the movie, you're going to be thinking the killer is somebody else at every moment, and hopefully it comes to a surprise to everyone towards the end there when that's revealed.
And I suppose Emilia, in terms of special effects, in terms of costumes, outfits, all sort of the blood, the gore, in terms of that, I imagine you spend a good few hours in makeup every day. Was it exciting? Was it exhilarating to see what they could come up with in terms of wardrobe? And dare I say, were there ones that you had to take a selfie or a picture of yourself that you couldn't sort of believe that what they had produced or created for you?
Yes, I actually have some pretty disturbing selfies. But yeah, the special effects and the prosthetics team on Founders Day were amazing. And a lot of the takes we could only do once because of the rigs that were set up and just the complications of setting up the scene again after the blood. It was definitely a team effort, but I think everyone's going to be very pleased with how it turned out. It looks really great.
And Emilia, in terms of the stunts, were you sort of proactive? Did you sort of get fully involved in it? Are you a girl that likes to get the bumps and the bruises to show that you're, dare I say, you're paying on the job? You're sort of, do you like to have those sort of memories, the nasty little boo-boos? And were there a few of them in terms of Founders Day?
I like to think that I'm a tough cookie and I would love to do my own stunts, but at the end of the day, I'm quite the princess. So I did dabble in a little bit of stunts myself, and we had a great stunt coordinator on set as well. And throughout my career as an actor, I've had a few bumps and bruises through some stunts, but on Founders Day, yeah, I mean, it was a pretty safe set, but of course, with the whole slasher theme, there was a lot of stunts going on.
Yeah, and you mentioned a sort of princess character. Were you almost like a Cruel Intention Sarah Michelle Gellar, where you were the sort of the apple of Mammy's eye in one sense, with one eye looked at her, and then the minute she was gone out the door, the other eye sort of sprung into action. Is that was there almost like a two-sided coin in terms of Lily?
I will have to let that play out for yourselves once you're able to watch the movie.
Okay, perfect. And Emilia, I do believe you have a bit of Irish heritage and you a bit of Irish DNA. And obviously, with the surname McCarthy, you couldn't really get more Irish. You might enlighten us a bit, a tiny bit about that, if you can.
Of course. Yeah, my dad's side has Irish heritage. My grandpa on that side, his family was Irish and they immigrated slowly to Canada, which is where my dad is from and where I grew up. But yeah, McCarthy, it's Irish and it's definitely on my list to go visit soon.
Yeah, and we have a sort of a powerful sort of a female cast with True Founders Day, and I imagine the friendships that you made in terms of shooting, are they still going on even to this day? Are yourself and Naomi Grace very close? Are you constantly still texting each other and communication with each other?
We are actually. We became very close on set, especially with this type of movie where there's so much going on and we really have to have trust in one another. We became very close, and Naomi also lives here in LA, so we are able to hang out, and we were all able to go to the UK to London for a Fright Fest in August for Founders Day. So we had a little reunion there, which was really great. So, yeah, we do keep in touch for sure.
And Emilia, I suppose you mentioned there before we came on air that you've another project that is making its debut, dare I say, tomorrow. It's a global release. You might enlighten us about that maybe for a minute or so in terms of what's the project, where can we find it, and a bit about it.
Yes, SkyMed is a medical drama. It's 9 episodes and it's airing internationally on Paramount Plus tomorrow. So if you have Paramount Plus, you can go ahead and watch the second season tomorrow, and the first season is already up.
Okay, and on that note, Emilia McCarthy, so for the final 30 seconds, you might enlighten all our audience, all our listeners, why they should go out mass to their cinemas, to the movies on January the 19th, roll up on their recliner seats or with their popcorn, their Maltesers, their Pepsi, watch Founders Day, and what's in store for them, Emilia?
I think it's a very classic film to watch in theaters. I think we've gotten so comfortable in sitting in our living room and watching things while we can go on our phones and et cetera and pause to go to the kitchen. And this is just the type of movie where you have to fully immerse yourself in the movie theater experience, and